One of the things that makes glioblastoma so difficult to treat is each tumor is composed of many different types of cells, all of them tumor cells. All of them can remake a tumor if they're missed in surgery, but because they have very different behaviors in different states, that means they take different kinds of therapies to really get at them, affect them, and kill them. In the lab, we've been trying to address how the cell diversity of the tumor makes it more resistant to therapy. We get samples from the operating room of brain tumors. We'll chop them up and we'll grow them in actual three-dimensional miniature tumors that that we culture and sustain in the lab. Doing this, the cultures are much, much larger than a traditional cell culture on a plastic dish. So we have millions and millions of cells growing together, communicating, and competing with each other. And that sets up microenvironments. That creates a need for cells to cooperate with each other and also to adapt to their environment, just the way that they would within an actual tumor. And that changes their behavior. Because of this, we can see some of the cell diversity that exists in patients, and that gives rise to a lot of the therapeutic resistance that clinicians have to deal with. I don't believe that we'll ever actually have just one perfect therapy that shuts down one perfect target and gets rid of the entire diversity of the tumor. So I think what we need to do is mentally chop up the tumor into pieces that we can research, can treat, and we can cure. Then we can combine those different therapies rationally together to figure out how to cure or treat the tumor as a whole.